Wow, what a beautiful sight. Qué lindo es estar con nuestra gente, ¿no? Graciela Olivares was born in Arizona and raised in a small mining town without the landscape. Most of the townspeople were Mexican Americans and their families, and most worked in the mining industry. When she was 15, unfortunately, Graciela had to drop out of high school. She was only a junior, but her family needed her assistance in order to survive. She moved to Phoenix and found a job at a Spanish language radio station as a secretary, then was promoted to an engineer, then became a radio personality. She used her radio show to offer the Latino community a platform to address their growing needs in education, in employment, and in civil rights. The U.S. Civil Rights Commission held a hearing in Phoenix and invited Graciela to address the panel. Soon after that, President Lyndon B. Johnson appointed her to the National Advisory Council on Economic Opportunity. Graciela returned to her school to finish her education and was asked by Notre Dame to attend their law school. She did. And in 1970, Graciela Olivares became the first female graduate of the Notre Dame Law School. Latina. She was a founding member of the National Organization of Women. She directed the University of New Mexico's Institute of Social Research, and President Jimmy Carter appointed her to the Anti-Poverty Agency, the Community Services Administration. All this from a young girl who didn't let circumstances get in her way to succeeding in life and succeeding in working for the betterment of the Latino community. NCLR also benefited from Graciela's tenacity and commitment to justice for all. Over 40 years ago, as a board member, she insisted on equal representation of men and women in our board of directors. Most of us can see when change is needed, but it takes a real hero to confront the situation and create the change needed. That was our own Amazing Grace. The Graciela Olivares La Raza Award is bestowed upon an individual or organization that has made significant contributions in promoting the interests of Hispanic Americans. The legacy of Graciela Olivares' work is represented in this award. In the case of this year's Graciela Olivares La Raza Award honorees, it's two heroes. One, a priest, one, a layman, who worked together to bring on a much-needed change in their community. We are proud to present the 2012 Graciela Olivares La Raza Award to a dynamic duo who carry the same passion and commitment to our community as Gabriela, and that is the Reverend James Manship and Pastoral Council Leader Angel Fernandez Chavero. These two men have worked together to aid their fellow parishioners in East Haven, Connecticut, many of them immigrants, advocating for undocumented high school students. They created the St. Rose of Lima Education Task Force and raised funds for books and expenses. Then they made a bold move to approach local colleges and universities to consider these students for admission on their merits. It was a simple and direct request. Some thought the plan was unconventional or just plain crazy. But in the spirit of ask and you shall receive, the plan worked. A number of parish's dreamer students are now on the road to attending college. Reverend Manship and Fernandez Chavero also realized that law enforcement and government officials were targeting immigrant Latino parishioners for harassment. In the good Reverend and Fernandez Chavero prayed on what they will do to fight for their friends and neighbors. Their prayers were answered with a call to action. Courageously, the two men stood together and brought justice to those who were wronged, but not before the good reverend was taken into custody by the East Haven police. Let's turn to the screen to see more of these two exceptional awardees, Reverend James Manship and Angel Fernandez Chavero.
In the summer of 2008, St. Rose of Lima started getting reports from parishioners about encounters they'd had with police in East Haven, Connecticut.
We were starting to hear stories of some of our folks getting harassed. Really, when the story started to multiply, just to know a good number of these folks, it's like, wait a minute, this is actually something far more serious.
No, simplemente ni siquiera los dejaban subir a sus autos y los pedían por documentaciones y muchas veces vimos cómo los llevaban arrestados, se llevaban sus carros.
We feel like where we go to asking for help. My daughter make a call to the police department, but she didn't get any answer.
But it wasn't until early 2009, which was a really particularly egregious incident that happened, in which some officers really mistreated a group of Latinos.
This young man explained how he had been, after the booking procedures, he'd been brought to a holding cell in the police station, and just with one officer and him in the cell, and the officer grabbed his shirt and started banging his head against the wall repeatedly. And the young man said, I thought he was going to keep doing this until he killed me. I thought I was going to die.
And it was those folks to the parish, to the community here, that said, no, this has got to stop. We were documenting instances in which the police were harassing the Latino community. I happened to be there with a small video camera while they were harassing this Latino store owner.
Sir, what are you doing? The reason why you have the camera on me?
Yes.
Why is that?
I'm taking a video of what's going on here.
Well, I'll tell you what, I'm going to move that camera.
I asked personally at Mass, I asked people, please trust us. But we need stories. We need you to testify. We've got lawyers here. We will take down your stories, and we're going to try to use them to put this together in the police department to send to the justice system. Same justice system that you might be afraid of, but we're going to do our best to use it in good faith.
Just in the first Sunday, we had over 100 people that came forward and told their stories to the Yale Law School. Folks.
But the blessing in that terrible incident was that the Department of Justice started its own investigation. After a scathing report on police abuse of the Latino community, the chief of police resigned. Thanks to Father Manship and Angel, things for the Hispanic community in East New Haven are changing for the better.
That culminated not only in finding by the Civil Rights Division and pervasive racial profile by members of East Haven Police Department against the new Latino community in and around East Haven, but also earlier this year in federal criminal indictments of 4 of the officers of the East Haven Police Department. That is a rare thing.
Fue una lucha de una comunidad, de una parroquia, de una organización grande, no de 2 or 3 personas, de una verdadera comunidad.
Even though we're from many tribes, that here at St. Rose of Lima, we form one people under God. In St. Rose of Lima, it's a para Dios, and most people respond, no hay extranjeros. For God, there's no stranger.
The NCLR, I am honored to present the 2012 Graciela Olivares Larraza Award to Reverend James Manship and Angel Fernandez Chavero.
I've got this teleprompter thing, and I just don't know what to say. This is unbelievable. Thank you, NCLR, for this decision to help bring to a national audience what we're trying to do, the struggle that we're facing, because it's not all over. And hopefully we can inspire others to do the same in communities across the country. And before I actually start with the teleprompter, I'd like to acknowledge that my wife is here, Philomena Ayala, and that my sister, Maria Elena Fernandez, are here to also enjoy this moment and to celebrate. And believe me, without the support of my wife, this couldn't have happened because I was not home a lot. Hopeless. That is how we felt in 2009 when our 6-foot-tall white gringo priest was arrested. If he could be arrested for no good reason, what did that mean for the rest of us who are far less privileged than him, some of whom are among the most vulnerable? Yet today, 4 East Haven police officers await their criminal trial, and their entire department is under federal scrutiny. How? A wise man once said, "From the depth of need and despair, people can work together, can organize themselves to solve their own problems, and fill their own needs with dignity and strength." Our parish community believes deeply that human life and limb are a very special possession given by God to man, and that no one has the right to take that away in any cause, however just. We know that any state, any law, any ideology that fails to recognize the worth, the dignity, the rights of man, that state, that law, is obsolete. Over 100 believe this so strongly that they risked all to tell their stories. Similarly, parents of college-bound youth refuse to give up on their dream for their children. This is why I will repeat to you that this honor belongs foremost to them. They, much more than Father Jim or me, acted to live their dignity. They are my heroes. Though they believed in themselves, there's that same wise man who said that you're never strong enough that you don't need help. So without the Yale Law School Clinic, without Terry Freeman or Kathy Aaliyah, without the organized Jewish and Black communities, we would not have students graduating from college or a safer East Haven. The implications are clear. St. Rose is not successful because we care about ourselves or just our parish. We know that human dignity is universal. Whether we say, "Si se puede," or "I have a dream," we fight for the dignity of everyone, including our opponents. As another wise man said, "I can never be fully what I want to be until you have a chance to be completely what you want to be." Our ambitions, said Cesar Chavez, must be broad enough to include the aspirations and needs of others for their sakes and for our own. Let us honor all who have suffered and who have fought on their behalf by giving ourselves an ambition even higher than that of righting injustice against Latinos. That out of the depth of our despair and need, we resolve that we will be the last people to ever suffer injustice. On behalf of St. Rose, the Latinos of Greater New Haven, and all offended and oppressed people, I accept the Graciela Olivares La Raza Award. Thank you. Father Jim.
I just want to make it clear to everyone, I'm not Vice President Joe Biden's priest. Though he tried to suggest that today. I got enough problems already. Not that I wouldn't mind, mind you, but I got enough work at St. Rose. It is an honor to accept the Graciela Olivas La Raza Award, and I would like to do so on behalf of the many parishioners of St. Rose of Lima, New Haven, Connecticut, folks who can't travel freely in our country still because of their status, immigrants from some 18 Spanish-speaking countries and Brazil, who through their struggles, joys, and hopes have helped me grow as a follower of Christ and a Roman Catholic priest. Whether urban legend or not, some time ago it was reported that a nationally elected official remarked that he was headed to Latin America and that he had a brush up on his Latin. I think it was another vice president at some other time. I think my Spanish is a little better than my Latin, but I would like to share with you the motto of our state, the state of Connecticut. Qui trans tulit sustenet. He who transplanted still sustains. From Psalm 80. You brought a vine out of Egypt. You drove out nations and planted it. A motto that hearkens to the first settlers to Connecticut and reminds us that immigration is part of human history and is part of our nation's history. With that experience, God continues to call us to know him more deeply through liminal moments, to invite us to go beyond, to places where we have not gone before. From our worship as Catholics, the Mass, we are called to enter into anew into the life of our families and of our community, to respond to the movements of the divine that spark our conscience and move us to act rather than to be acted upon, to unleash the transformative power of the divine love into our community. I am proud to live in a nation that reverences religious liberty and values that freedom, even when at times it can be difficult. As Catholics, we strive to practice a consistent ethic of life from conception to natural death. We are not a one-issued community, but we are concerned about life in all of its stages, about the dignity of human life that is based on sacred scriptures, that each person is created in God's image and likeness. God is not weak. God is not powerless, impotent, but God is a God that acts, and we believe he wishes to do so through us. So when the dignity of one person is affronted through fear and intimidation, it is an affront to God and to all of us, and it demands for justice action. St. Rose of Lima is one of the founders of congregations organized for a new Connecticut, Connect, an organization of churches, synagogues, and mosques dedicated to train and to develop leaders to act on those movements of God in public life, rather than to be simply acted upon. We consciously make an effort to develop leaders in our community of 18 countries, as I said, para Dios no hay extranjeros, for God there is no strangers. Our leaders, whether they're from Ecuador or Guatemala, from the 15 Mexican states represented at the parish, are called to know each other by name and by story. And it is that those collective of stories that resound in our hearts that call us to act. Trained leaders from the parish Ecuadorian community, Rita Quesada, Elio Cruz, Carmen Zambrano, and others, organized a massive meeting of Ecuadorians from Connecticut with representatives of the Ecuadorian government. After laying out their research and compelling stories of inadequate attention from the consulate office in New York, I'll never forget this, Rita put the question to those three officials from Ecuador, will you work with us to establish a consulate office here in Connecticut? Yes or no? After a brief pause, in unison, they responded yes, and the room erupted. There was no supplicating. There was no begging. a noble and dignified people acting for the common good, for the well-being of the community. A year later, a consulate office was opened in New Haven that serves all the Ecuadorian community in our state. So many more stories that we have. The experience that we've had in East Haven, while we can legislate and bring lawsuits and the law will continue to work through, it's called us to a deeper conversion and to understand that the transformation that needs to take place is one of hearts. So I'm proud to say that the St. Rose of Lima leadership, our Latino community, is engaging with other communities of faith in that East Haven community of people who are puzzled and astonished that police acting in their name could have perpetrated such horrific things against a segment of the population. So many more stories folded into the daily struggles, traumas, and triumphs of our prisoners speak of the power of a noble people acting on their hopes and dreams and renewing our faith communities, our cities, and our country. As you know, many Latino Catholics, the ones that speak Spanish, that is, not Latin, are very, very devoted to Our Lady of Guadalupe, La Morenita. Soy Guadalupano. And through our Mexican sisters and brothers from 15 Mexican states, remind me, like Mary, who appeared to Juan Diego in Cinta, pregnant with the child Jesus, we are all a mestizo people, a mixture of faiths, cultures, and ethnicities that through it all, God wishes to be known. In these liminal moments, at life edges, beyond our comfort zones and preoccupations and preconceptions, to live in a place that we have not lived before. And I believe that this is an invitation that the St. Rose of Lima parishioners and the immigrant community today makes to all of us. And there we will encounter the divine, and together we will build a new society. In Espanol, hay un cántico muy familiar en nuestra comunidad. Algunos dicen que nada pueden cambiar. Lucha por un mundo nuevo. Lucha por la verdad. Ven con nosotros a caminar, Santa María, ven. It is with this deep, deep experience and sense of accompaniment that I'm honored and privileged to be the pastor of this wonderful and vibrant community who's opened their hearts and their lives to me, who have been able to trust myself and the leadership in the community to be able to go beyond our comfort zones and to be able to truly live out our call to be a transformative force in our world. Que viva Nuestra Señora de Guadalupe y que viva Cristo Rey.